Hi, everybody. This is Jean Ketchum, Aging But Dangerous, and I have a really special guest with me today that I just, she's one of my favorite people, and she has helped me so much. But she has a company called That's So Organized. She's the founder and CEO, and it's Joni Bastable. And so, Joni, I can't wait to share you with all these followers.
Hi, Jean. I'm glad to be on. Thanks for having me.
Well, you're welcome. Anyway, how's it going these days for you? Tell people what you do. I mean, what it is that you do. You're an organizer.
Right. I help people get organized in their homes and businesses. So I do hands-on organizing, virtual organizing, and productivity consulting.
Oh my gosh, Joni, I just latched onto that virtual organizing. Tell us about that, because everything's virtual today.
Right. Virtual organizing has not been very well known. Our industry, just in terms of professional organizing, hasn't been very well known. So the fact that people can do organizing virtually is really exciting and so pertinent in this time. So virtual organizing, kind of what it is it's organizing, but it's doing it, it's having a professional organizer come alongside you virtually to help you get organized. So it's different. So just to kind of step back to what residential organizing is that's when we show up and we're at your space and we're doing the work with you, we're hands-on, we're hauling things out, we're sorting together. Well, virtual is different because we're not in your space, and so we can't be doing the actual organizing together. So it works a little bit differently, but there's kind of pros and cons to both ways, and it's a different, and it works for some people, but not for others.
But Joni, how does it work? I say I'm not real computer savvy. I'm a little bit better than some people. But tell me how it works. How would I show you a picture of what I'm trying to clean out, organize a drawer or a bookshelf? How would I show that picture to you on my computer?
Yeah, so what we would do is that's kind of one of the requirements to see if you're a good fit, is that if you would have some sort of device that you could use, whether it be a phone or a tablet or a laptop, so that when we do our, particularly the initial assessment, we would want to see if you have something so that I could see your space, right, mm-hmm. and see what you're trying to organize. And so phones work really well because they're very mobile.
Right.
So if I can see your space, And then what I do as well, like let's say it was your closet that's behind you. Let's just take that for example. Mm-hmm. So the way we would do it is we'd start out where I talk to you similarly to hands-on organizing, and I find out what are your goals, what are you trying to accomplish, are there any kind of limitations that we need to know, and we have kind of a whole series of questions that we go over so that we can get to know you and get to know what you're trying to accomplish to align with your goals. And then when we're doing this initial assessment, then I'd want you to kind of, maybe you'd have your phone and we'd be doing a video conference, so you can use, depending on who it is, you'd use Zoom or FaceTime or Skype or one of those type of things, of applications. And then you would walk over, if you were had your phone, and you would show me so I could visually see your closet. And then once I'm able to see it, then while you're showing it to me, I'm asking you questions and talking to you about it.
Joni, you know what I was thinking?
Yeah.
And I was going to ask you is, does that mean, I mean, this is very exciting because, you know, does that mean that I could take my computer, I could go to my closet floor, I always have so much trouble, there on the floor with my computer and show you all the different things and you could help me with that?
Right. Yeah.
It's just like you being there.
Right. And it's less in terms of, so during, depending on who you are, like if it was just kind of the bottom of your closet and it was a smaller thing, we could sit on and talk for a couple hours. But for most people, it's going to be more, they're going to have to do what we talk about in between. So the virtual session might be for an hour, and then we'll set up a time like a week later where we'll check in. And in the meantime, they'll have that homework. So virtual organizing for a larger project than the bottom of a closet would that person has to be able to work independently and be motivated to do things in between the sessions.
Yeah.
Because with hands-on, a lot of my clients don't do anything in between sessions.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're not the best fit then for virtual.
And what I love about what you do, and I've always said this to you, is that you get to know their personality.
Session where you have your phone or tablet or something, and we're on video, and we would walk through, I would ask you questions like I would if I was standing there, and you would kind of tell me about your space and what you're wanting to do. You would point out kind of, well, this is my problem area over here or whatever. You would tell me that. And we would do that on Skype or FaceTime or Zoom or some sort of application where we could virtually meet like that. And then I would be able to provide a plan for how you would go through your space. And what that does is that help people will get overwhelmed with their spaces and they don't know where to start.
Right.
So that's where you can still, a lot of those same organizing principles that work when we're together work virtually. It's just a different way. I'm just not hauling bins and hauling donations. So that a key is that people have to be able to physically be able to do the work. And because I'm not there to do all that.
Right. Well, and I think what's really important, Joni, is that when you were helping me in my office, that you really got to know me. You really get to know the people and how their mind works and how they think. And so you kind of make everything around that. I mean, that was really eye-opening for me, that you really could understand. I mean, I kept thinking, I'm just so... really got down on myself. I'm really awful. I can't organize my papers. I don't know what to do. It should be so simple, but it's not. And then you just made me feel so much better because you said it was normal. A lot of people are like that. And so I love that you go into the personality of the person to try to get how they think so you can work with them and it makes it easier for them.
Yes, definitely. Organizing is very individual. And what works for one person may not work for another person. And that's why when I'm with people, like let's go back to your closet for an example, the way it would work is that I would suggest something and say, well, what do you think about this? Mm-hmm. And then you might say, you know what, I won't do that because of, this.
Or right.
Whatever. So I'm an idea generator and a problem solver. And so we talk about it. And then I always tell my clients, you've got to be honest with me and tell me if I suggest something that you think is not going to work, I want to know. And then once we set up something, then we'll check in because it'll be like, okay, how's that working?
Yeah.
Because it's trial and error. There's no perfect system we have to try it.
Right. And isn't it like, aren't I right when I say, like organizing is like there's so many roadblocks for people?
Yes.
And you just got to learn how to get through that roadblock and it's, you help to do that, because I know a lot of times I just get like it's like a brick wall in front of me and I can't get past that brick wall. And then you helped me see a lot of things that I would not have seen. Well, that is so interesting. I think, so many businesses now are going virtually and I think it's exciting and it's just too bad we're having to deal with all this, but still these businesses that are, I think it is exciting. So I'm so glad that this is, and you belong to a national organizing association, right?
I do. Yeah.
So this is an actual profession. This is not just you know, Joni sitting there trying to, you know, help her neighbor organize. This is a professional business, and I think it's exciting. A lot of people don't even know that it exists.
Right, right. There's
so it's spring cleaning, Joni. What tips do you have for spring cleaning?
Yes, spring cleaning. So the great thing about this season where everybody's home is that they are available, more available, to do their projects since they're at home. The challenge can be that they may not feel prepared to do their projects because kind of like what we talked about, Jean, is that people might, let's say their project is a garage, they might open the garage and look at it all and they still are visually overwhelmed. They just jump in. And the problem with just jumping in is they pull everything out and they start trying to weed through it, and they don't know how to do it, and or they buy a bunch of bins, they buy a bunch of things, but they don't know how to get everything done, or they're having trouble making decisions. They run out of time, and then it actually ends up in a worse state than when they started. So planning is really important. And it's also helpful that if it's a space in your home, you want to get everybody's buy-in, right? You've got kids home right now. So kind of something I would recommend organizing now is to involve your kids, right? This is a really good time to focus on teaching kids life skills. So if you have other family members that are there, you involve those family members in in the process. Mm-hmm. And you also want to get buy-in from the family members, so that if you're redoing your garage, you want everybody to be on the same page. And then you can also get help with that. Mm-hmm. And so the next thing would be to kind of put it on your calendar, right? And and have it be where it's a time that you protect and say, okay, this Saturday, you know, from 9 to 5, we are going to organize our garage, make sure you have, that you figured out all the roadblocks, that you know what you're going to do with the things that need to leave. Don't buy your supplies yet. You don't want to buy supplies for things and organizing products until you have, until you know what you're going to organize and what is leaving. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of some of the initial tips on kind of getting started.
Yeah. And that makes so much sense. And I think that's what everybody does, is they bring everything out and then they start putting it back. And sometimes it just goes right back to where it was. So yeah, that's a good tip. Well, I really think, you know, I think you're so fabulous with what you do. And it's great to have that profession out there. You know, like I say, we just have to educate people, Joni, and let them know that organizers are out there, and you know, they're professionals, and they're, you know, they can help you get organized. And I think all of us are trying to do that with this self quarantine. So anyway, my dear, thank you so much. I just appreciate you more than you'll ever know. Wow. With my own organizing. So anyway, and I'm so glad you're a part of Aging But Dangerous. You're just a wonderful sponsor for us. So have a great day, Joni, and thanks.
Thanks. It was great to be on, Jean.
Okay.